This is the day we celebrate.
This is the day
of the Lord.
This is
we are alive. Church together. Bon Diablo, Barapo,
Peanut. Let us rejoice.
Rock Road.
Let us rejoice and be glad.
Have a feast, let me hear you.
And be glad in it.
Oh, this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Oh, this is the day that the Lord has.
We marching left, right, left, left,
right,
left, right,
brave.
Let me see them.
Left, right,
we are the
right,
army. Right, who is she that coming forth?
We are not afraid. We are not ashamed. We are the army of the Lord.
One more time.
We are the army.
We are the army of the Lord.
Come in the battle. Come in
the
battle.
Lord, the word is our song.
Come on, church.
It is the feast day. March into victory. And
feast day, people. Let me see your hand.
Right, left, right, brave.
Somebody sing.
Left, right, left,
we are fighting
right,
the battle. With the weapon, the rosary.
We are not afraid. We are not ashamed. We are the army of the Lord.
We are marching
in the light of
the Lord. Our ladies in front of us.
We are marching in the light.
She's the weapon for Satan. We go with her.
We are marching in the light of God.
We are marching in the light of God. We are marching in the light of God.
We are marching. We are going up. I don't know about you. We are going.
We are going up.
I don't know about you.
We are going up together.
All those outside, let me see your hands.
The name of the Lord.
We are going up.
We're going up together.
Prosper.
We're going up to prosper
in the name of the Lord.
Lift Jesus higher.
A little higher. From the earth to the door to see.
He said if I be lifted up
from the earth I was drawn.
Then on to
a little higher, a little higher.
A little higher.
Come on, church.
A little higher.
Come on.
From the earth for the world to see. He said if I be lifted up from the earth
you could do better than that. Higher, higher. Come on, church. Feast
day! Higher, higher.
Come on, Harold.
Higher.
Lift Jesus higher.
Come on, Carol.
Lower. Satan lower.
Super. Supernatural power.
Take a grip. No matter what the people in the world say, hold on and never let go.
Need somebody help me lift Jesus.
I need your hands in here.
All hands in the air.
Somebody praise the Lord.
Everybody present Jesus. Present Jesus. Present.
Somebody pray.
Praise.
It's a new day, it's a new feast day. It's a new church family.
Everybody present Jesus.
Present Jesus.
All hands in the air.
It's a new feast day. It's a new church. It's a new.
It's a new feast.
Lift up, church.
None who's weeping.
Meet me in the church. I'm back to
meet me in the church. Anyone who's weeping.
Meet me in black to knee. Come on.
Meet me.
Lord, we praise you. Lord, we bless you. Lord, we thank you. Somebody praise him in our sight. Somebody,
everybody, praise him, Jesus. Praise him, Jesus. All hands in the air. Praise him. Praise him.
Let me hear you.
Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him.
I'm not hearing y'all outside.
Praise him.
I'm not hearing those outside.
Praise him. Praise him.
Praise him. Come on, church.
Praise him.
He's worthy. Lord, we praise you. Lord, we applaud you. Lord, we glorify your name. Lord, we bless your name above all of. Lord, we bless your name above.
You great, Lord.
Lord, our desire is to worship you. Our desire is to imitate that woman who said yes always. She said yes, and she meant yes, and she did yes. Open your hands, church, and tell God your desire. We have so much people here today with us. From Tabakit and from so much places, Charette's family is here and Gorilla family. And we just bring those who have died in our community. Yesterday, our brother Andre and our sister was hard to leave the cemetery. There's so much grief.
This
and
is my
what's your desire for Mass?
Desire
just to attend or just to
honor you.
My desire is to return to you. My desire is to build church. My desire, Lord, is to come back and imitate this woman, the greatest disciple. The woman of God, a woman of rosary, a woman of faith, invincible woman. Lord, I praise you with all the nothingness in my life. On this great feast day, I know graces flow. Lord, I know graces are flowing, Lord. Come bless our families. Lord, bless this land. Bless this awesome, simple, obscure community. You still reside in them as you did in Bethlehem. Lord, I want you. I want you now.
I give you my heart.
You make so much of mysterious decisions.
I give you my soul.
I want to return my soul and my mind and my spirit, my body to every breath that I breathe.
Every breath that I take.
Every moment.
Every moment away,
Lord,
have your way in me.
Lord, I lift all my heart.
This is my
desire
to honor you, to worship you, and to venerate the woman that you choose to bring salvation in your womb. At the hour of death, we pray. I want to call on her to intercede. All that I have. Lord, everything that I have is a gift on loan. I'm just a tenant. You are the owner of the vineyard. Even my family is on loan. Lord, I give Jared back to you. Andre,
Lord,
Josephine, Catherine, Panasing from this community.
I give you my soul.
I live for you and those who are going today. Every breath is a gift. Every breath is mercy.
That
I thank you on this feast day. Let praises flow. Let praises rise.
Lord, have your way in me.
Lord, have your way. Have your way.
Lord, have your way in me.
Lord, have your sing, church. I want to hear those outside participate.
Lord, have your way in me.
Have your way. Lord, I surrender. I surrender all to you. We just spend a few moments of what you bring before God on this feast day. Angels are here and archangels and the throne of graces. This is a mystical body. This is a litany of angels. This is not a service. Whether you're boring or you're not attractive and you just come here just to keep, God's still going to give us graces. And just open yourself, because you can't throw water on concrete. So we thank all those who have joined us from so many communities and the media and the altar servers. And Lord, we thank you for our community, because you delight when people come together. That's what makes you happy. And we make you happy by coming together. Satan dismisses. Satan separates, divides, make us live in silos. And that's why we are in communion and we are Catholic, universal. Close your eyes and bring your petition. Our Lady is here. She's real. And we honor her, because she said, from this day on, all generations shall call me blessed. So we bring sin before God. And she was sinless. That's her other homily. Because she couldn't have sin to bring sinless. If she brought sin, he would have sin, and he couldn't redeem sin. I don't know how God worked it out, but he just had a mystery, and we honor his decision. So all the deaths that are happening, we have to honor it, because God allows everything to happen. I don't know why. Don't ask me. But when you trust that it's for the good of those who love, that's when he will open and break, make a breakthrough in your life. So close your eyes and see how we have sinned. And put this woman who has never sinned and always said yes. She had an engagement. She had a project. She wanted family. Joseph lived a few blocks, a few buildings away. And she said, no, Joseph, God's will first. And God made her the greatest disciple that ever lived, the greatest saint that ever lived. And only person in the Bible that said full of grace was to her. All the other saints were not proclaimed full of grace publicly, but she was. So bow your heads and bring sin before God. Sin of idolatry, you know what it is. I always tell you, something less than God, created by God, you try to replace God with. It's some part of creation and some part of creator. In the Bible, you see today, everything is on loan. We are just tenants. There's an owner. Stop playing God. And he's going to come and ask you, where's your fruit? And sometimes he will curse the tree, you fruitless fig tree. Let him never curse us. And say, woe unto you, you man of duplicity. You worship with two tongues. You come when you want. You live how you want. You never obeyed. And that's greater than sacrifice. Close your eyes and bring how you treat people. That is the only way you could prove how much you love God, by treating human beings you could see, made in his image, and who have a divine spark according to his mysterious plan. Our bodies will rise again, and be careful what ink you put on it. Be careful what you feed on it, because this body is for resurrection. Make it a sacred temple. Make it a sanctuary where God lives. What you wear. And finally, creation. Place hot, because man playing God. And we trying to clone people and all kinds of stuff, because we playing and feel we are God. How have we sinned? And have we made the sacrament of reconciliation? Have we received communion unworthily? St. Paul says, you eat and drink your own condemnation. This woman is guiding us. When you say Mary, she says Jesus. She takes no credit. And that rosary is our weapon. Satan can't take it. You know why? She always says yes, mean yes, and did yes. We say yes and end up no. We say no, end up. We two tongue. So it can't depend on us. Because Satan is the father of lie and no. So all of us have to give an account after the age of 7. You have to stand before God naked. And that's why the church says, don't say we believe or we confess. You have to stand up and say, I confess to Almighty God.
My brothers and sisters, I have greatly sinned. In my thoughts and in my ways, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do.
Through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, blessed to Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints,
and to my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
And bow your head, so many people celebrating the feast day today. Rosary, church and school, all over the world. May Almighty God have mercy on us. May he forgive us all our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Can we cry out for mercy? Lord, look at this country. Look at the papers. Look at the death. Look at the rape victims being killed and murdered. Look at what we're doing to our children. Look at us not giving an honest day's pay work. Look at many people not coming back to church. It means, Lord, have mercy. It means, Lord, treat us better. Don't punish us. For those who have eyes and ears, look around. We are a holy mess. Look around.
Look around you. Can't you see?
So much trouble, Lord. There is something called fake piety. There's something called fake peace. Looking good and peaceful and holy outside. Underneath is, oh, still waters run deep. Sometimes we're looking good in church and we're in a mess home. Somebody help me cry out. Send a pillar of mercy to God.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Lord, will you forgive us? Lord, if you mark our guilt, nobody could stand and survive. Only by your mercy we stand. Forgive us, Father. Forgive our country. Lord, waste some money, Lord. Look at money. Waste it. And poor people do have access to essential resources. Suffering and pain. Let all suffering and pain turn into a purpose. Help us to understand your mystery. Thank you for our small community doing so much in the neck of the woods. Somebody sing mercy.
Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Father, we thank you in advance. Whatever you ask of God, he grants us. Maybe that's why we're alive. Some old woman played the rosary somewhere. Somebody said the rosary somewhere. For us, we glorify God in advance. Let's glorify God. Let's claim our healing, claim our mercy, claim the joy and grace of Easter today. As angels join us and archangels, we welcome them. Glory. This is what the angels sang and shepherds
glory
sang.
Glory to God in the highest. And on earth peace to people of the world.
Glory, glory.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of the world.
We bless you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, God Almighty Father,
glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to people of the world.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of the world.
Lord Jesus Christ,
only begotten Son,
Lord God, Lamb of God,
Lamb of God, Son of the Father,
you take away sin.
You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
You take away, Lord. You take
you
away.
You take away the sins of the world.
Receive the prayer.
Receive our prayer.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth peace to people of the world. Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth peace to people of the world. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord.
You alone are God.
You alone are the Most.
Jesus Christ,
with the Holy Spirit,
in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And the people sing.
Amen.
People on a journey sing.
Amen.
God praise, Lord, we glorify, Lord, we magnify you. Lord, we bless your name, Lord. Lord, we thank you for another feast day, Lord. Lord, we revel in saints,
King of kings,
archangels, thrones, our mother, blessed mother here with us. And so many, we thank you for this mystical body of Christ. We bring all our prayer and all that is within us, all your prayers and all your trouble and all your grief and all your joy, and we make one, we call it a collect prayer. In this one prayer, on behalf of the priesthood, we raise it up. All prayers. Now, as said on this day, pour forth, we beseech you, Lord, grace into our hearts, Lord, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ, your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, Gabriel, may through the intercession of this blessed mother, Virgin Mary, by his passion and by his cross, be brought to the glory of resurrection, who live and reign with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please sit with us to the first reading. It will not be in your Catholic news. The first reading is taken from the feast, from the Acts. We're going to read about the Marys and how God allowed them to build church after resurrection.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After Jesus had ascended into heaven, the apostles went back to Jerusalem, a short distance away, no more than a Sabbath walk. And when they reached the city, they went to the upper room where they were staying. There were Peter and John, James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James, son of Alphaeus, and Simon the Zealot, and Jude, son of James. All these joined in continuous prayer, together with several women, including Mary, the mother of Jesus, and with his brothers. The word of the Lord.
Just bow our heads and Mary was part of that. She built church, and after resurrection, she continued. Scripture says, including Mary. And we too must include her, because God included her. God chose her. And if he did, we must imitate thus. You have a choice, but if God did it, what God says is. Close your eyes, and from now all generations mighty shall call her blessed. We ask our psalmist to bless us.
Your response, the Almighty works marvels for me. Holy is his name. My soul glorifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. Marvels to me, holy is his name. He looks on his servant in her nothingness. Henceforth, all ages will call me blessed. The Almighty works marvels to me, holy is his name. His mercy is from age to age on those who fear him. He puts forth his arm in strength and scatters the proud hearted. The mighty is, holy is his name. He casts the mighty from their thrones and raises the lowly. He fills the starving with good things, sends the rich away empty. The mighty works marvelous to me. He protects Israel, his servant, remembering his mercy, the mercy promised to our fathers, to Abraham and his sons forever. The Almighty works marvelous to me.
We listen to our second reading, and the second reading is taken from the first reading of today's Mass. Isaiah talk about a vineyard, a press. God is building a whole garden for us, and we are taking the fruits, and we're running away with it. Or we're not bearing fruits, and he says he will take it away from us and give it to somebody who produces fruits for him, because he is the owner, he is the master, and he is God. A lot of us taking God's talents and giving it to our families and the world and the school and the place. And he is a little angry about that.
Second reading, a reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare for all people a banquet of rich food, a banquet of fine wines, of food rich and juicy, of fine strained wine. On this mountain, he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples, and the shroud enwrapping all nations, he will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on it. For the Lord has said so. That day it will be said, "See this, our God, in whom we hope for salvation. The Lord is the one whom we hoped. We exalt and rejoice."
Church, let the word minister to you. Thy word. Thy word is light.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet.
Lord, illuminate our
mind. Unto my heart.
Thy word.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet. And a light.
Somebody sing, thy word is light.
My path, thy word.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet. And a light unto my path.
Amen. We sit.
Amen.
And we thank God for so many people here today. Amen. In our Amen. Small little community, it's apparent that God uses small, obscure people and places to show his greatness. Small little virgin, 13 years of age, behind God's back. People say, why didn't God choose Josephine or Teresa? No, a poor Jewish who had a boyfriend, who had a plan, who had a project. God preserved her, and she became the beginning of salvation. And that's why we celebrate the Rosary. The reason why today, apparently there was a big war, and the soldiers prayed the Rosary and they won the war. There are many people who pray the Rosary and win wars. Salim is a Muslim from the RFC school. Is he here today? Anyway, and I respect Muslims and that's fine, but I never introduced him to Catholicism. I like to inveigle non-Christians, like more Christian-oriented. He came to church last week. He's in RCIA. You know what he told me? He says that any hour late in the morning, 2 o'clock, that's mid-morning, twilight, you know, that is Lagahu moment when the sun now coming in the dark. Apparently, in New York, they say the only time that New York never sleeps is between 2:30 and 3:30. That's the only time. But that's Lagahu time. That's where evil and good struggle. And he says to me, and I never thought it, he says, I have a rosary, and it's called a 2 o'clock rosary. And this is a non-Catholic, this is Islam holding on to the rosary because it's a weapon for Satan. And you know why? Because Satan can't take yes. And she said yes all the time. And she meant it and she did it. He just can't take she. So when you just show him the rosary, no matter where you are, he runs. You all know the story with Father Theodore. He was in Haiti and they were, after First Communion, they do simidimi after with the children. And they went down in the valley and they was calling the spirits. Well, Obi, all kind of thing. And they're beating the drum. And the more they beat the drum, the spirits didn't come in because the child just make First Communion.
And then somebody spoke out a prophetic voice. And they said, the spirit can't come. It have a man on the hill. And he's rolling some beads. Father Taylor was praying for the child. Satan can't enter if you pray the rosary reverently. You can't just babble it. Eh? You have to say it and mean it and meditate it. Hail Mary, full of grace. The Lord is with thee. That is God's word. He said, God, I repeat the word to you. And then Holy Mary, Mother of God. And we add this as Fatima. Pray for us sinners. Just pray for me because there's intercession. And there's intercession. And you could ask and you could go to God direct. That's fine. But God, grace is built on nature. God uses secondary. God used candle. He used bread. He used light. God uses people. And that is why in the gospel last week, at 11th hour, he says, why are you jealous? All of you are being called to participate in my life. And just being church and being baptized is a lie. So why are you competing and you want rewarding when you're already in? Because you are working for the kingdom. And that's why if you're working for the kingdom and you have the rosary and you're praying at the hour of death, you don't have to worry. Because yesterday was so sad with Andre's death. I know the daughter didn't want to leave the cemetery. And sometimes you just have to trust the mystery of God. That's why it's important. Mary to the very end was one of the first to see resurrection. And she's alive. She can't be dead because on the mountain when Jesus went up Mount Tabor, they said Moses and Elijah came. If they're dead, how did they come? And God never said Moses and Elijah was full of grace. So there's no way Mary could be dead because she brought him. She's full, he said. So if you see Moses and Elijah, how come? On top of that, all over the world, there's apparitions about Our Lady. Whether they believe it or not. They say when the world in trouble, she comes. In Fatima, she came 3 times. In Lou, she came 9 times. People of God, she's appearing every day in Medjugorje. It means the world in real trouble. In 1917 was a war, and she appeared. So she's always appearing to guide us. And that is why the parable today is frightening, because the last two parables was two sons, and today is a vineyard. And it was coming to the end, and the scribes and Pharisees won't get in it. And he says here clearly, because I'm going to die. I am going to Jerusalem, and I leave in this last parable. And the parable is simple. The parable is that I am the landowner. You are not, you don't own your life. You don't own your breath. I am the landowner. You are just a tenant. First lesson, some of we play God and we play, we know God. And because we educated and whatever, we're the priest, we have everything. No, you're just a tenant. There's an owner. First lesson, and he owes everything. And he's turning them upside down because they were greedy. They were power hungry and they were unfaithful brats. And not because, it's not because man wanted nothing, you know. It's just that man just greedy. If you look at the papers today, all the police cars have $500 million just wasting. Because they could get a new car, so the old car just gone. And that's taxpayers' money. That's just a tip of the iceberg. Because it's not man has nothing, and man poor and want dal rice and bhaji. It's that man is the most craviest. Craving, you want a knife, you want a fork. You get a fork, you want a plate. Running down material things and God's people. First lesson. That's why he was telling the parable. He says, I am the landowner. I am the vine, you are the branches. And cut off from me, you can do nothing. If you cut off from God, you become dry leaf. And dry leaf only good for fire. Today he said, if you don't produce, I will hand it over to others. And that's frightening. Because you have to produce. Not for his good. For your good. You have to show all the goodness and all the talents and all the treasure what you're doing for the church. Very sad. Very sad when we could suck and want intention only. And don't breathe nothing in church. Yesterday I went to a meeting. And the woman said, Father, I'm not inviting no new people because they only come in when they want to be teacher in the church. So they want to be active in the church. To put on I'm part of Legion Mary. So they will suck to get money. It have a God. God knows the intention. That's why he says today, I am the master. I give you a vineyard. It's rich, it's fertile. It's not an orchid, it's not original, it's wine. You know what wine means? It intoxicates you. It means you have to be, the spirit has to be lifted, the soul has to be pierced, and your mind has to be fulfilled. If you go to a mass and you don't get your spirit lifted, and you don't get your soul pierced, and you don't get your mind fulfilled, you're not intoxicated. You're in an orchid. You're in an orchard house. You're in orange. It's wine. It's to get drunk on the spirit. That is why it's a vineyard. It's the most beautiful. It's a garden. You're going to come back later when they mess up the garden in Adam and they mess it up in Gethsemane. He says, I will rise in the garden. He rose in a garden, and heaven is a garden with a meal. The man had given up. The images are real. You see? And the parable is that there's a vineyard, it's wine. The only people I think have it right is Hare Rama, Hare Krishna. You ever see them get done? They're getting on Hare Rama, Hare Krishna. And they're intoxicated. Our music, our preaching must have, your spirit must be lifted. Your soul must, can I hear you? Spirit lifted.
Spirit lifted.
Soul pierced.
Soul pierced.
And mind fulfilled. If you're coming again, I think, forget it. If your spirit not lifted and if your soul not pierced, the music had to do it. The hospitality had to do it. The Catholic news had to do it. The priests had to do it. The banners had to do it. It's a whole holistic form of worship. Intoxicating. It's a city. Heaven is a city. It's animation. It's dynamism. God's glory is in the aliveness of his people. So anything dead out, God not dead. Heaven is alive. So the first thing is a vineyard, he says, and it's wine because... Thirdly, and you were thinking wrong, he walked away. He says, I'll leave it up to you because it's freedom. If you love somebody, set them free. If you don't love somebody, ask them where they go in and where they and how come. That's possession. When you love somebody, you empower them. You don't entangle them. You empower them. Scripture says he walked away. He says, Platini, that whole vineyard is yours. I will build a vine press around it. I will put a tower. I will protect you. I have to protect the church. You cannot leave anybody coming to church all the time. We have to be careful. The church has to be protected by the sacrament, as people just use the church. That's why he said, I'm going to protect it. We have to protect the sacraments. Who come? Who go up? Everybody got, no confession, communion. We have to protect. We have to pierce the ears. He says, I built a tower around. I guard it because you, even when you're including people in the church, you can't include people bad habits. We include people so we're on a journey of conversion. We can't include you because you like this and you have a gender and I must accept your lifestyle. So if you want to get married to a dog, I'm a dog lover, let me get married. I'd include them. Include them mean come dog lover, but we better get converted. You can't love God, you can't love dog. To marry a dog, I mean. As a matter of fact, there's a girl in New York, because her parents don't watch what she's doing online. She meets an online thing with men and women who have talk like animal. Big stinking men talking like animal and courting her child. So she in love with a dog. But behind the dog is an old man. That's where it's going. And they're asking us to include. Yes, we include you and your dog. But you can't be involved with a dog. We can't bless sin. And that's why he says, I built something around it. Be careful what inclusivity means. Inclusive, anybody could come, you know. But I can't bless their lifestyle. I could bless you. Be careful. Don't walk along the faith. Yesterday, a woman came and she wanted to join the Legion because she wanted to get a teacher's certificate. God sees everything. You have to put boundaries. And that's why, but freedom means accountability. Freedom means you have a response. You have to respond. He expected peace where you get war. He expected worship where you get false piety and idolatry, as a matter of fact. He expected solidarity. He get greed. I want, where the food? Marshall, where the food? He expected temperance. People have attitude. He expected community. He get exclusivity. Don't say I didn't tell all, yeah? We run a risk, Catholics, to be operating in silos. It have communities who feel as church. This is one holy mother church. And the mother church is cathedral, whether they like it or not. And Rome have a mother church. You can't pretend that Platini have it all and know it all. First thing, you expect a community, you didn't expect an exclusive club. It's called a social club. I said, old people, and they drink anything. I said, it's church. No. You have to include and recognize your mother church. Other churches have small churches. We call them respectfully, and that's their stuff. So when they break up, they're breaking up. When we break up, you're not part of the Catholic Church. There's one holy apostolic Catholic Church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. So you could want how many want. People leaving that their business. You could go, but you're not a Catholic Church. It have no fractions. He expected obedience, and he got disintegration. So he was messed up. What do we have to show for our talents? What do we have to produce? Because sometimes you're getting the fruit, and you're worshiping the fruit. It's on loan. It's very, you know, he hedged around it. That means he's protecting with angels. As I said before, angels on your shoulder, they're going to leave you. It have angels protecting us. It have people praying. The man and the monk praying. That's why we're surviving. Somebody playing the rosary. That's why the devil can't come. Somebody protecting me in the rosary convent 7 times a day, before sun, mid-morning. People praying. That's why we're surviving. So you had to come to church. Maybe, but you're surviving on somebody's prayer because he's protecting us with the ministry of angels and the law and the ritual and the sacrament and the revelation. It's very hard, but you have to put the boundary around the vineyard because it's producing wine to intoxicate you and good fruit, not orange, wine. Church is sad. It is difficult to guard people who don't listen. It's hard to put boundaries around people who don't follow instructions. It's hard to put boundaries on people who feel and know God. It is hard to put boundaries about people who only want to use God. Next week, we can have school. I don't have a problem, you know. Cheryl never stay home, but it will miss Mass. Don't wait for the cemetery, you know. You will stay midnight day. And your child will say, Mommy, why didn't you tell me? I told you. I'm innocent. I don't know. You dig a vineyard, a wine press, because he's fertilizing it, because his spirit and worship must have spirit in it. Some men come to church and the entrance seems like a funeral. Where do you go from? Oh God, all the wake up now. And some men go to church and rocking. And as soon as you go in, you get your heart pierced, you hear your spirit lifted, your mind fulfilled. That's what you call penal. Can I get an amen? Teacher Mildred, say if you lie in church. He leased it. After he bonged it and he leased it, he says, love is freedom. I want you to cooperate with me now. That's all I'm asking you for. Cooperate with my grace. And that's what Mary did. Every stage of the game, she said, yes, I'm cooperating. He said, wine run out. Be careful about wine. When you're using wine, it means blood. It means Last Supper. The man building a case, you know, for heaven. It's not wine is used because they refuse the wine. He built it in the parable and he built it in the wedding. Heaven have plenty of wine. Because it intoxicates your spirit. It makes you alive with him. It makes you like a city. And that is why he says you must cooperate, you must participate, and be privileged to be part of the divine life. You should have no worry. Poor me, no. You have a divine spark. Mary was able to take that. When you say the wine run out, she was able to say, Jesus. When you say Mary, she doesn't mediate. Everything in 1 Thessalonians is done through the body of Christ. Throughout Mass, it's through Christ. Yes, pray for me, doctor, but it's through Christ. Yes, pray for me, Father, through Christ our Lord. Everything, the only mediator is Jesus Christ. Mary's not God. When you point to Mary, she said, Jesus. You're just asking her because God said full of grace. And she's the best intercessor. Aaron and Moses were intercessors. Monks were intercessors. Why not choose Mary? Because she cooperated in the divine life. She participated, right? Because she understood what love is. Love is that you give me freedom, I'm human, but I will participate and I will delight in it. You are tenant, I spoke about that. When you recognize your life is not your own, and your children on loan, and when you recognize that God owes you nothing, and God ought to explain to you when he killed you, or when he called those, God ought to explain to nobody. God allows evil. Everything that happened in the world, he's the master, maker of heaven and earth. God, Satan can't do nothing without God's permission. But why he does it, I don't know. Why does God allow an HIV child? Why does God allow this country to have so much corruption, millions and billions, and the poor have no food? That's not my work. I can't judge on God's judgment. We are just gift. We participate in. We have a vineyard. He called us in the vineyard. He boundary around it. Good. You're overlooking it. He's not there. He's empowering you. Just participate and bear your fruit. So when he come to you naked, leave what you have to show. I was part of Legion of Mary. Next, what you have to show. Because sometimes the people he send, the messengers, will kill them. He sent messengers because they were able to see the infidelity and how they're moving. They mocked him and they kill him. They sent, the scripture says, that's all the prophets. First set, second set, and third set. Remind you of the three sons. And they kill God. But that's not the end. He says, the same gardener they throw me out of. That is why they pull him out of Jerusalem on Good Friday. It says, scripture said they threw him out of Gethsemane, again the same vineyard, and he rose in another garden. He's not giving up on your redemption. The same garden that didn't bear fruit, and he gave it to somebody else. Scripture says they wanted to eliminate God. That's why they don't want to say Christmas again. They want no crosses in churches again. Uh-huh. And the Sabbath is no longer, 90% of people don't come to Sabbath again. People want to eliminate God. They want to take him out of the garden. And they did take him out of the garden in Gethsemane. Scripture says they roll him out. That's symbolic. They took him out of the vineyard. He says, no longer. I'm not giving up. And he rose in a garden. Same vineyard. The man is telling you, it's a whole big circle. But the stone the builders rejected shall become the cornerstone. Because the Israelites messed me up. But you are the new Israel. You are the church of God. Adam messed me up. My son is the new Adam. Eve messed me up. E-V-A. I give you a new R-A-V-E. R-V. Mary's new Eve. I'm not giving up because it's not cheap grace. There'll be consequence. I'm going to take it away from you. If I was God, I would have fight. Taking away, it means God is non-violent. He just took it away. I wasn't going to take it away, so I'd fix you good. He didn't retaliate. He didn't fight fire with fire and evil. He simply handed it over to somebody who could bear fruit. Will God take away the church from us? If 90% aren't coming and the 10% poppy showing, would God take away the church? And hand it over to somebody who's serious, non-violently. Close your eyes. Because he promises he will act non-violently and take away those who don't bear fruit. After you get the vineyard, you get the hedge, you get the press, you get the tower, you get the privilege, and you can't produce fruit of peace, harmony, life, justice, fidelity, obedience, life, respect, and you can't do that. I'll take it away from you and your children. Powerful. Powerful parable for the scribes and the Pharisees who were craving things of God, people of God, the family given to them, and didn't want God. We ask God to give us him today. Give me you. Close your eyes and recognize that the master left the field. And go home and contemplate this brick parable and see how Mary was an integral part of that because she participated. Close your eyes wherever you are. And let this last parable before Advent, because they had many parables, they had the two sons, they had the 11th hour, today is the vineyard and the tenants. God intervenes. The garden is rest, enjoyment, and excitement. And that's what he meant. And he wanted fruits, and he wanted excitement, and he wanted something returned, not for his good, for our good, to produce something, what you get, you have to give. Close your eyes and I am the vine, you're the branches. Said God, I want you, I want the vine to feed the branches. I want me to put the perspectives and the point of view in the right place. And I want you to show me how Mary cooperated straight through as a great intercessor. She's not dead. She is using Jesus as mediator. She can hear our prayer. She's sinless. She's appearing. And she's not babbling prayers. We're not babbling prayers. We are just saying, like, holy, holy, holy. The angels repeating prayers. And saying the weapon, so the man on the hill, devil can't come. Keep a rosary, according to Salim, for the 2 o'clock in the morning. 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, It's twilight moment. Everything else.
Everything else.
Just bear fruit. Are we bearing fruit? And will you take it away from our families? Will you take our children away? Will you take our families away? Will you take my priesthood away? That's his decision. Because he gave us a vineyard. He gave us a wine press. He gave us a tower. He gave us a boundary. Oh God, what more you want? All he asking for you is to be an instrument, a mission, a steward. Here I am, Lord, on this feast day. I don't want to abuse and exaggerate. I want to reconsecrate myself to the absolute center of which Mary points us to by saying the rosary daily, by meditating on the life of Jesus in the rosary, not just babbling and saying things with the lip. Everything else is secondary. Hindus use beads. Mystics use beads. There is power in beads. Roll your beads and tell Satan, no way. Oh, give me you.
Lord, give me you.
Everything else is
Lord,
craving. Everything else
you.
Is greediness. Everything
Lord,
else is a risk of losing all
Lord,
and give it to somebody who will use it well and bear fruit.
It's me, oh Lord. I'm on my knees crying out to
Lord, I'm a tenant. Lord, I'm nothing more. You are the master. Why I plain, God? Plain, I know it all and have it all. I'm just, you fence it. You put a wine press. You put a tower. I could participate. I could cooperate. I have a privilege like Mary to be part of salvation history. Oh, give me you, master. I want you. I want to produce fruit for you. Fruit that lasts, that endure. I want to give away my life.
Lord, give me you. Lord,
I want to operate from the middle of the wheel, not the circumference, not the peripherals. I want to find peace in you.
Everything else can
absolute you. In the middle of the wheel is you. And let everything revolve around it. And wherever the church calls me, I'll go. Platinum on Diablo at the harvest. I'll go in. I just go in because I belong to one holy Catholic and apostolic church. Don't take away the church from me. No people don't come, Lord, and they come for the wrong reason. Father, keep your church alive, intoxicated. Lord, make your spirits lifted. Lord, make our souls pierced. Lord, make our minds fulfilled in the church. Let worship be intoxicated. Since when you get a dead old church? Oh, heaven is alive.
Lord,
and the glory of God is manifested in the aliveness
Lord,
of his people. Mary is alive. She's pointing.
Lord,
she went to the wedding. She's a woman of animation. She must have danced.
It's me,
she was in love. Human.
Lord,
never sinned. But she knew God. And she knew the vineyard. And she knew the master. And she knew she was a tenant. And she knew she had to bear fruit. Blessed the fruit of your womb. Give me you.
It's me, oh Lord.
I'm a tenant.
I'm on
loan. I'm a pilgrim.
So
and my family on loan. Give me you.
Give me you.
Imagine a Muslim know about a rosary.
And give me
as a
you.
Weapon, as a lasso.
Everything
how much of us have a rosary? How much of us have a rosary by our bedhead? How much of us have it under the pillow? How much
you.
Care about what a rosary is about?
I hope it's
people
not
just
too
pray
late.
Not sure. All the contemplatives,
Lord,
all the monks, all the religious,
you.
Some lay people do it.
Lord,
praying for me to you.
Lord,
I want a new direction.
Lord,
I want
give me you.
This last parable. Shake me up now.
Lord, give me you.
We have that. Lord, we pray for Jarell who has died. His family, Andre from Rock Road. Family can't take the death. Lord, death is so hard. For Josephine Cooper, Catherine Panasing from this community, Lord. George Abrella, founder of this church. And so many are dying today. They'll have to hand over the keys soon. It's not fear, it's just that I am the vine, you're the branches. Cut off from me, you go catch your tail. He just can't come every feast day. You can't come when you want to. You can't when you want something. Everybody had to come. All the time. How come everybody going to work all the time? How come everybody go to school all the time? Something wrong. Would you take it away from us? How come the country have so much money in debt? So much money wasted? So much in the church. How come priests are not preaching the gospel? How come we are not our lives worthy of our vocation? How come we just take any wine to get drunk for pleasure and not to worship? We pray for those nuns, those nurses in the hospital today, locked on now, batch 6, 16 years. We thank you online, batch 6 in the San Fernando Hospital, who are online now. Shade, special attention. And Shanice, birthday. Everything else is on loan. We are only pilgrims. This is the last parable before Advent. Listen to it. But the stone the builder rejected rose in the same garden. There's a consequence. It will be taken away. This is not cheap grace. This is not mercy. Mercy and love, yes, but justice.
Lord, give me you.
For those who refuse to listen and refuse to bear fruit, our tenacity is in jeopardy. Our tenacity is at risk. You will catch me in an end. Family can't save us. Priests can't save us. People can't save us. Work can't save us. And education can't. Only the master of the vineyard, the owner, his name is Jesus Christ. Give me you.
Lord, give me you. Lord, give me you. Give me you.
Everything else
can wait. Give me you, and hope it's not too late. Lord, give me you. Lord, give me you.
Lord, we want you. We want the master. We have you. But we just want to. We just want to be in love with you. We hum that quietly. We pray for our synod. Lord, all the cardinals and the bishops are in Rome this month, trying to build a new church so that you wouldn't take away the church from us. Our church is hemorrhaging. In Boston, 265 churches are closed. And you know what happened in America comes home? We had a challenge in Barrapaw. Lord, you know the challenges we face. It's coming home. For this church, Lord, Holy Mother Church, let us not build silos. Everybody know I'm plain God. Could you have a degree in theology? You're the priest. That's pride. On the eve of the new phase in synodal journey, Lord, we pray the presence of the gospel will become alive to work in the vineyard, as in the parable, that people may accept the privilege to cooperate and participate and to bear fruit and to work like Mary. She built church. She was at Calvary and she was silent. All she could have said is, can you turn my son over? You don't deserve this. But we kill God and we continue to kill him. In the name of God. Lord, give us hope. Help us in a minor place. And give us a breath of hope. And all the participants, our beloved bishop, he will build a Caribbean church after our heart. That protocols, proposals may spring forth from the listening of the Spirit. Lord, send your Spirit again in your church. Let there be a revival like in Vatican II. That the entire people of God, in a dynamism of communion, may feel that they are truly participating in a life, Lord. A church where the Spirit is lifted, where the soul is pierced, and the mind is fulfilled. Every time we come to worship, everybody will do their part. For theologians, Lord, may the gifts from God not go to their head of wisdom and revelation accompany their contribution to the assembly in Rome, so the gift of faith may become life alive in God's people, especially in the Caribbean church. Lord, I pray for young people, Lord, who have walked away. And they say they're not coming because it's not relevant. They say it's boring. They say they don't see witness. They don't see a connection between what we say and what we live. They're seeking truth, authentic witness. They will look beyond what they see and take the battle. And not let the church be taken away from us because of their non-involvement. We pray on this synodal journey, Lord, that they will feel increasingly involved, and we will open places for them to hand over the church fully in the mission and stewardship. They intermingle. When you're on mission, you have to give back. I pray for all those who gathered here, those who have come, Sabi and all those from Tabakit and Lee, and so many others listening to us from all over the world, from London and Croatia, always on. A sister from Boston, struggling with a diminishing church, is online now. There is hope if we only recognize we are tenants. We must bear fruit, must delight in mission and stewardship and cooperation of divine life, and bear fruit. That's all, lest it be taken away. Pray for the Gorella family who's done all the work here in this community. Joel and Brianna, the young people here. Every Sunday they are here. Every Sunday. Lord, out of nothingness, you brought something. From an obscure village, an obscure woman, you brought salvation. And maybe you will lift up the Platinies of this world. There is something in poverty that you marvel at, because we are totally dependent on you when we poor. We're not dependent on our monies and our image. Lord, we pray that each one of us here will come in communion, that the wine that is going to change in the blood of Christ, that the garden that they pull them out through in Gethsemane that we refuse in the vineyard, be resurrected, and we will participate on this table as we move and be witnesses, and generous witnesses, and digital, so nobody has to marry a dog. In a world which we live, and your private intention you can bring now, God will hear you. Whatever you ask of God, if your heart is clean and your commitment and your decision is real, He will. God knows, and God permits evil and mystery. Is He? He's the master.
Give me you.
Lord, give me you. Lord, give me you.
Just let the mother graces flow.
Lord,
she's here. Mother, send your graces. Mother, blessed mother, send your graces. You can stand and receive your grace church wherever you are. Open your hands and trust God. The Master is here.
Lord, give me
and the Master's
you.
Mother.
Lord, give me you. Lord, give
Amen.
Me you.
Speak, Lord, your servants listen. Let the Holy Spirit live in you, because you've been baptized, many of us who have been. For the Salims of this world who aren't, there is a spirit that lives somewhere that tells them you need a rosary at 2 o'clock in the morning. God will break barriers. Close your eyes and give praises to God. Can we just thank God? There's a sweet spirit. Lord, we praise you. Lord, we praise you. Lord, we glorify. Lord, if there's any prophetic voices here, can you speak through them? Can we bear fruit of prophecy? On your feast day, Lord, the Mother of God, Queen of the Holy Rosary, from this generation, all shall call you blessed. Weaken the spirit.
We express on each day, and I know it is the
thank God for this church, the privilege to participate in this church, His church. We say the creed of our church.
In this place,
and I know it's an angel on the throne.
And I know it is the Spirit of the Lord.
There is a sweet spirit. It's called the Holy Spirit. It pierces your
There's
heart. It penetrates your soul. And it fills your mind. Only if you allow it. And Sheldon's anniversary. They've come all the way from Tabaki. Can you give them a round of applause? They just came in. Welcome, Sabi. And we pray our prayer as we raise our right hand. Privileged to be part of the vineyard. I believe in God.
By the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered of Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended into hell.
On the third day, he rose again from the dead.
He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. Welcome to judge on the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, life everlasting.
Amen. And that's what we believe in. And we sit. Please give generously. We have to do a lot of work on the yard and the fence to make this day so. So Simon, they spend a lot of money. So basically, we have to get some money to replace the cost to prepare our feast day. Amen? Especially foreigners.
Number 23. Thank you.
and take my heart, and in your love we'll walk together. Wash my sin away with your blood, and in your mercy drive away all my pain. Let your love carry me on, and feel your love making me strong. Strong. I
feel your love making me strong.
You're on.
Turn me round, facing your life, and in your love I'll love everyone. Let your love carry me on. I feel your love making me strong. I feel your love making me strong.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Father, through your goodness, we have received this wine we offer you, the bread we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, to become for us the bread of life. Lord, by the mystery of this water and wine, blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Father, through your goodness, we have received this wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, Lord, may we be acceptable to you. Lord, may our sacrifice on this altar be pleasing to you. Lord, wash my iniquity. Because this is mystery, and this is what he left from the garden, we just shroud in mystery, just enter into the mysterious divine life. Bless God, angels ascend, descend.
We bless the Lord, and as incense goes up, so our breasts fill the temple. So our prayers fill the temple. The people cry glory. The people cry glory. The people cry glory to the Lord.
Sing, we bless the Lord.
We bless the Lord.
We bless the Lord.
We bless the Lord. And
grant, we pray that we may be rightly now conformed to these offerings we bring, and so honor the mysteries of your beloved Son, as to be made worthy of the promises of Christ, who live forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
and with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty everlasting God, on this great solemnity on the feast of the Holy Rosary. For by overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, Redeemer. Without losing the glory of her virginity, she brought forth into the world the divine light, Jesus Christ. And through him, angels praise your majesty, dominions adore you, powers tremble before you, heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May your voices now join with theirs on earth with one voice. We all now acclaim. Show them he'll rise again, and that's why we celebrate this. His death and resurrection we celebrate, and he rose in a garden. They went to the garden, they went to the vineyard. Heaven is a new Eden, and our job is to re-Edenize this world. What are we doing? Otherwise, he will take it away from us and give it to somebody else who's serious. Lord, you're holy indeed. You're the font of all holiness. Come make holy therefore these gifts, we pray. By sending down your spirit upon them like dewfall, they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, he entered willingly into his passion. He took bread, he gave thanks, he broke it, gave it to the disciples, and he said, take this, all of you, eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you.
My Lord.
I return my all in mission and stewardship. Close your eyes, church. God is present. Don't waste this opportunity, lest he take it away from you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples and he said, "Take this, all of you, drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant. It will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." My God, my all, I return all. Heaven on earth here. Lord, don't you ever take away this from us. We will become communion. We become the broken body of Christ to the poor as you command us. We pledge. Save your people. Mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world.
For by your cross,
and resurrection, you are set us free.
Please have your hands clasped to show our disposition of worship. Intoxication. It's not orange juice. It's wine of astonishment and action and aliveness. Therefore, we celebrate the memorial of your death and resurrection. Lord, we offer you the bread of life, the chalice, salvation. Giving thanks, you've held us worthy, Lord, to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, Lord, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church, Lord, divided throughout this world. Bring out the fullness of charity. Together with Francis the First on mission and assembly now, Charles Jason Gordon, our beloved Archbishop, also on Synod, all the clergy in retreat this week. Now remember those who have died, for whom this Mass is being offered, whom you have called from this world, Lord, why you alone know. Grant that they who are united with your Son in a death like his may become one with him in resurrection. As all we pray, Lord, they'll see your face. Lord, remember all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection and those who have died in your mercy. Father, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. Through the Blessed Virgin Mary, Our Lady, Queen of the Holy Rosary. 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 All the blessed apostles, all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. Father, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. Father, we may praise you. We may glorify you in this vineyard through Christ our Lord. Amen. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory, all honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, we join hands as one family. We join our Platini community. So powerful, small, obscure, but so deep and effective. Prayer that he taught us. In his presence, we sing as a community, as a body, in solidarity.
Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be your name.
Hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Forgive
us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead
Lord, you let deliver us from that evil one.
And deliver
to live for our lives and live for ourselves and live for our family. That's what he wants us to do. Live inside, not outside. Lord, deliver us from that father of lies, fruitlessness. He wants us to worship our own and get us tied up. That's his job, to fight for our eternity and our children's eternity. Lord, grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin. Keep us safe from distress as we await the blessed hope coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom,
and the power of God. Last one to these stubborn, greedy, crazy, grabbing scribes and Pharisees. I'll give you a vineyard. I'll give you a wine press. I'll give you a tower. I'll give you a fence. I'll give you wine. Oh, go bear some fruit now. So I'll take it away. Now look at our sin. Look at the fate of this community today on your feast day of Our Lady. And grant peace and unity in accordance with your will. Where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your
offer somebody happy feast day. We are here
today.
Happy feast day. Jesus, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world, happy are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy
that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Jesus Christ keep us all safe for everlasting life. Bow your heads, should prepare for communion, and those who are not in a state of grace and not in the communion of teachings of the church, please come have your, with your arms crossed across your chest for a blessing from this, the blessed species.
Soul of my Savior,
O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, praise and all thanks. The promise of Jesus, whoever eats my body and drinks my blood lives in me, I live in them. I will raise you up on the last day. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in this day of battle. Be our safeguard. Cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through this world seeking the ruin of our souls.
Hail Mary, full of grace.
Can you join your hands and make us pray to our Blessed Mother all over the world, churches, schools dedicated to her. Rosary celebrates.
Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of the womb.
Fruit.
Jesus,
Mother Mary, from this day's generation, all blessed.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of death.
Wisdom,
gentle
obedient
woman, quiet
cooperating
life
with the divine plan.
Morning star, so strong and bright, gentle mother.
We didn't choose you, God chose you. That's why we
you
honor,
are chosen,
we venerate, we don't worship you, we can't.
By the Father,
you are a mere human being, but a saint. We don't
you are chosen,
adore you, we don't idolize
for
you.
The Son,
we just pray through you.
You are chosen.
Lord, we praise you for Blessed Mother. We praise you, Lord. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for choosing
you,
us.
Lord.
Lord, let this woman,
we worship you.
Blessed are you among women.
We magnify your
we
name.
Thank you for feasting, Our Lady, Queen
of the
King
of Kings. You're the Lord of Lords.
Lord, let our hearts be pierced. Animated at worship, like how she did at the wedding feast, she did at the Last Supper, she did at the Pentecost room on the cross, and now she's celebrating the banquet in the new garden, in the new vineyard, in the new Eden. She's the new Eve, peaceful,
quiet, love.
Teach us wisdom.
Teach us love.
Teach us love.
Teach us wisdom.
Teach us wisdom. Teach us
Amen.
Love. Teach us wisdom.
Lord, your servants listen. And if anyone gets a word of prophecy, a word of encouragement for our community before we close and have a meal together on this great feast day of our community, you can stand and give your word before we close. Amen. Pray for vocations.
Speak now, he's listening.
Speak now, your servants in the vineyard, your tenants, listen. Peace for where you live. The Holy Land is in war. How can a holy land be in war? Pray for peace. Hallelujah.
Nothing is ours. We are just tenants.
We are just mere tenants. We are pilgrims on earth. Everything is temporary. And whatever you're clinging to will be taken away from you one day. And the people of God say, I alone am the master, I'm the owner, I alone of God. Don't judge on God's judgment. And the people of God say, Amen. Amen. Increase to vocation, to priesthood, and to religious life. And to do the will of God, that's what matters most. Not only family, yes, great family. Why people are shunning away from? Because they want to get rich, maybe, and have a good image and say, my daughter went to so and so. Maybe it's the reverse. My daughter and son didn't do anything but went to heaven. People of God say, Amen. We have two more prophetic words, and we close. Thank God for our feast. Amen. Jesus must be first
in our
absolute
life.
First, and you must worship him in spirit. Let the mind be fulfilled and the heart be pierced, and worship be intoxicating. Not
we are keeping ourselves full.
Keeping yourselves full.
We are not emptying ourselves.
We are emptying ourselves.
And the time has come for us to go out.
Time
and to empty
out.
Ourselves,
empty
telling others
yourselves.
About Jesus
out.
And who Jesus is.
Amen.
Amen.
And to be filled. Amen. And the people of God say, Amen. Amen. We pray against violence. And all schools and teachers who are violently violated their vocation. Jesus today simply said, I will hand it over. He could have deserved to fight and shoot and kill because man deserved it. But he said, I will just take it away and hand it over. A God of non-violence. People of God say, Amen. Let there be peace. So we get in a very golden thread, church. And this is what Synod does. I think we get in a call to vocation,
and peace. Amen. So we continue to pray through that this week. A call, respond to your call to participate and to cooperate in the divine life of the divine master. And be here in peace against war. Sometimes the war is in our own selves. Sometimes the war is in our own families, in the workplace. We thank God for his word. We thank God for the opportunity to worship. And we thank God for all those who have come today and given everything back to God. Amen. Let us stand and pray. Lord, we pray, you are God and master of the vineyard. We are mere tenants. We are pilgrims. We are on loan. And just as we proclaim in the sacrament the death and resurrection in that garden of your son, so being partakers in his suffering now, we will go on mission and merit a share in his consolation and glory, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Please sit for community announcements. We want to ask Marshall, come forward. Can you give this community a round of applause for welcoming us and persevering in the vineyard every single Sunday, come what may. And our choir that comes, Rhea and Sharon and Daniel and Joel sometimes, come to make our liturgy animated. We thank all those who are moving out of your comfort zone. Elvon comes once every Easter. Just remind you, next big move is Mon Diablo, big time, country style harvest on November the 5th. Everybody coming down. If you don't come, other people will come. Assumption community is coming, all the penal people. And can I give a round of applause to Tabakit? Those in the house, Tabakit, can you stand up? Asabi, Leah, stand up. A round of applause. We are with you all the way from those from Point 14. We want to, where is Jamali? Is he there? Where's Point 14? So please, what day? Sunday, the 5th, we have a procession. You know the food down there is country style. You have, imagine country style pork, countryside curry, you know, Christmas curry. Everything is Christmas-ish, right? So you're getting some curry in the ham. No? You're getting some ham in the curry? All right. So that's, we have a big day. We have one mass, and Emmanuel community is coming down. They are locked on now, and some other communities will be coming to join us. If we don't come, other people will take away from us. Okay? Oh, sorry. I want to know who is the priest.
So, brothers and sisters, for St. Martin the Porus Harvest Day, the Migrant School and Good Shepherd is running two stalls, a Plinko stall and a card game. We are looking for some gifts for those stores, so you can please check me, whatever you have. If you have stocks at home from penal harvest last, if you have, you could just bring it, drop it by. Thanks so much.
And our young people be having
a stall too.
We're having a big stall. Your stall, please, because it's not about the money. Please. It's about the community and the oneness. So if you have a stall with old books, come. Duncan, whatever. Just get a stall. God delights in unity. Please read the gospel today. He wants us to be privileged and to understand your privilege. You participated in the life of the church. How can you not come? So we want plenty stalls. Still want the money. But I mean, we want plenty stalls, but we want you to come together. So Tabakit and Arima and all those listening online, you must come down. Imagine Emmanuel is coming down with a whole bus. So we're having a big, big harvest before Christmas. All those from Mon Diablo say amen. Michael, when the mic on, mic off.
Yeah.
I just want to pick up Joel, come forward. Joel, stand up. He's the eligible bachelor. Kelston, come forward. These are our two favorite youngster looking Christians. Kelston, come forward. These are young men. And these are from where? From Pinal? From where? And where's Aaron from? Oh no! Aaron come down, oh God. But Aaron like a girl from Pinal. These are the young men coming from this community. Pick them up. And Brianna, let's look at Brianna's.
Oh, we love you, love you, love you, yes we do.
And Brianna's birthday tomorrow. Amen. I'm going to give you a story of Abel. Abel was a little boy walking the streets one morning, coming to church, and we just grab him and we put a gong on him, and the rest is history. And he has an adopted family from Point Fortin. Abel? Amen. And people have seen him online, and he has a little struggle in his life, and that's what the church is about. So I really want to pick up Abel. Comes every Sunday morning and serve. Amen. And all those on Platini, stand up. All Platini warriors. Simon doing all the garden work. You're not from Platini. Everybody want to be Platini now. Use Platini? Use auxiliary member. We thank them every Sunday morning, and then we have Barapur joining us for now. You know, we had a little challenge with the building. All those from Barapur, stand up. From Pinal, amen. All those from Mondiablo, yes! And all those from Pinal and Rock Road. We're Rock Road, boy. And all Stormers. Thank you. So we have a lunch after, right?
Happy birthday.
And Monica. And Monica. Lord bless our community. So everybody meeting on November the
5th.
Where?
Mondiablo.
What time?
9.
No, we have a procession in the road. 8 o'clock. Okay? And then what time are we leaving? Midnight. We have in Parang, we have in Fet, we have in true Mondiablo style. Amen? Miss Monica, can you bless them? She bless the community and we thank God for it.
Lord, I thank you this morning for our young people here. Lord, I pray that you touch their heart, touch their life, Lord. Protect them from the hands of the wicked and the evil. Lord, I pray that you guide them and you lead them to the right and narrow path. Heavenly Father, I pray this morning, especially for Joel.
Amen.
Lord, I pray that you wake him this morning. Lord, I thank you. You sent him here first this morning, Lord, to help. And Lord, you bringing him in front of your altar this morning, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
And he gave praise to you. I thank you, Lord, because it brings so much joy in my heart.
Hallelujah.
Father, Lord, I pray that every young man and woman should come to the church and give thanks for their life, their parents, their family.
Yes,
Lord, I pray for this community, Lord, and the upliftment. I pray, Lord, that you protect us, Lord, from all evil, from the hands of the wicked and the evil and the bad thing that is going around in the world, Lord. Protect this little community and our brothers and sisters' community, Lord. Father, I pray and I beg you. Lord, you must be fed up with me by now because I constantly call in you. And Lord, I thank you again for Father being so much patient with us. You know, I admire him at sometimes because, you know, I know things doesn't go too right in Platonic, Father, but God bless you. God bless you tremendously for having patience. You know, I know when I see the walk and I say, oh, Father, Lord Jesus, take it away. Lord, you know, so we have to keep on doing that for one another. The choir especially, thank you all very, very much. Because this morning everything was kind of helter-skelter. I didn't know where to do what, where to put what. And, you know, so thank you all again for arranging, assembling nicely, beautiful singing and everything. Thank you all. Thank you all very much outside.
Maybe Kurt has another. We have two priests today, Daniel and Kurt. You must have the final say.
Sorry, this has been on my spirit for a while now, and I already got confirmation from the Legion of Mary that they would help in forming a Legion of Mary here in Platini. So all who would be interested, please, after you collect your refreshments, check me, I'll be here. We form an Legion of Mary here in Platini.
All right. Just want to tell you, sometimes the priest has secrets. And I have one joy from this community. One day, Miss Monica told me, Father, sometimes you come and have two people here. And we have one guitar. And she says, you preach and you celebrate Mass as if we have 99 people. The numbers don't matter. God comes anyway. So you cannot deprive a people. As long as you have one, we're good to go. So sometimes we come here alone, Miss Monica and Simon alone and Rhea, and we pray around the place. And that's my joy. Sometimes you have everybody, and they come and eat you out, and they come back. Can I get an amen? So just God comes in small people. God comes in obscure places. And look who he choose. Mary was from an obscure village. Somehow he chooses nothingness to bring somethingness. Amen? And that's the lesson for us here. And all of those who contribute, I really want to thank God for the music ministers who have gone out. Not to mention our media people. Come media! Come media! Yeah. This morning, Brandon came to my house 7 o'clock. And he have an attitude face. You know why? I leave in too late. Brandon, come here. You want to come early. Brandon, come. Barry, come. Everybody, come. Come, Israel. So they all were willing to come and serve, and Brandon was vexed I wasn't coming here at 7 o'clock. Water in my bed and wet. Barry, all, can we get media people playing the shy? Amen. All those online who give their whole life to media. Yesterday they were all by the cemetery. They went and give their whole services free, and they are really in mission. And they're on mission. There's something called stewardship. You can't be on mission and don't give away, right? And all it costed me was a leg and tie from Royal Castle. And we cut it up in 10. Amen? Any word, Brandon? Anybody want to say something quick?
God is good. What I got from Mass today was always, always, always trust in God.
Amen. Amen.
What I got from Mass today is say yes, mean yes, and do yes.
Yeah.
What I got from Mass today was don't judge God's judgment.
And as Father's controversial statements, as always, don't use the church, you know.
Israel has come early and hug you. Oh my gosh, Can you give Israel a round of applause? A special guy. To me, there's power when God speaks to our young people and they come back in the vineyard and they give back all, recognizing that life is temporary, right? And people have struggled bringing young people. Our young people have badged in our lives, amen? And I want to close with, not Brianna, Jasmine. Jasmine writes down everything at Mass. Can you get an amen, Jasmine? Right, so a round of applause again for our music ministers. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Barry, goodbye. Amen. Amen. Amen, amen. So we thank God for me, right? Just extend your right hand to bless the meal. Lord, out of nothingness came something, and we have provided a meal. And Lord, as we share this meal together, we share our lives with the men you go without. Imagine migrants having a stall. Would you take away the kingdom from us and give it to them? Maybe. As we share our lives, Lord, we share with men you go without. Not only physical food, but nourishment for the spirit and the soul. Lord, help the food feed the stomach, but let the company and the community feed the soul. Let us be a foretaste of that new garden, that new vineyard, that new Israel, that new Jerusalem, that new Eve you have prepared for us. It's called heaven. It's called a banquet. What is the profit of man to win the whole world and your family good and you lose God? Friendship forever. Bless us, O Lord. And these are gifts which we are about to receive. To Christ our Lord. Amen. The choir, we'll have some music after. While we eat, wait, food will come to us, okay? Let's stand and pray. The Lord be with you. And bow your heads. The Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May come down upon you, remain with you, preserve you from the devil, fruitless liar, clinger, and grant you nothing else but everlasting life. Go glorify God with your lives. Go on mission with stewardship. Thanks be. Have a wonderful feast day. Have a wonderful day. Enjoy your meal, stay, and fellowship. Walk around. Meet somebody you don't like. Meet somebody you never see. Please don't stay in a clique. It's not a social club. It's a community. Amen? Mon Diablo mixed with Platini. Platini mixed with Rock Road. Father mixed with those you don't like. Amen? That's everybody. Our recessional hymn is?
The Litany.
Is the Litany, Our Lady. Pray for us. Okay?
My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices. Most Holy Mary, Mother of God, Virgin of Virgins, Mother of Christ, Mother of Divine Grace, Mother of Savior.
My
soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices.
Mirror of justice, seat of wisdom, spiritual vessel, mystical rose. Gate of heaven, morning star, refuge of sinners, help for the Christians. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit
religion. Queen of saints, queen of the rosary, queen of peace, queen of the prophet, queen of the prayer, Mary Mother.
My soul magnifies the Lord and my spirit.